This is our wrap-up of headlines related to Star Trek and the Orville. We don't have any Orville news this week, sadly. No season four yet. You never know, though. You never know. All right, more accolades for Strange New Worlds, picking up three awards from the Canadian Alliance of Film and Television Costume Arts and Design. Costume Design Excellence in Sci-Fi Fantasy Television. It goes to Bernadette Croft for the episode The Elysian Kingdom. Excellent in Crafts and Textiles went to Anna Pancheva. And Excellence in Craft Award in Building. Both Strange New Worlds and Discovery were nominated for Excellence in Crafts Awards. And Strange New Worlds got. So congratulations to them. Jeri Ryan made an appearance on The Talk, not The View, The Talk, and she's talking about the experience of coming back to Star Trek, especially after being so vocal about wanting to move on after Voyager, and she was. When she was asked about the possibility of a Seven of Nine spinoff, she says she's learned never say never. I don't read into that any more than what it is. Now, Trek Movie is reporting that as we continue to get all these legacy characters of Picard, one face we won't see is that of Chakotay. Robert Beltran posting to Twitter a response to a fan question confirming there was an offer, but Beltran didn't like what they had written for the character, and he's much more satisfied with what he's doing over on Prodigy. And it turns out, according to Terry Metalis, the part that was written was for season two. This is the alternate timeline story with Chakotay married to President Annika Hansen, turned out to be the villain. And after Beltran turned it down, the part was rewritten and given to Issa Briones' father to play the part. But now you know that's why we haven't seen Chakotay in Picard. Now available for pre-order, Star Trek Lower Decks Season 3. Oh, wait, that's not the right one. I don't have a picture of it, that's why. This is the next story. Lower Decks Season 3 on Blu-ray, DVD, and digital. Over 45 minutes of special features and bonus content. It's a two-disc collection. Also includes audio commentaries from cast and crew. And note, the Blu-ray edition will be manufacture on demand, which is new. We'll see how that goes. All right, this comes from Portland, Oregon, by way of DailyStarTrekNews.com. A tea room formerly known as Lovejoy's, changing its name to Emperor Georgiou's Tea Room, named for Michelle Yeoh's character on Discovery. And on their website, they explain that it's part of an effort to reflect a more Star Trek approach to life. Infinite diversity and infinite combinations and such. Now, you'd think that the evil mirror universe Captain Emperor might not be the first person you think about when it comes to inclusion and tolerance and such. The Star Trek approach to life, you know. But anyway, the owners are named Brendan and Wellington Georgiou. So what are you going to do? Now we get to this picture here, where I jumped the gun a little bit. New from Playmates, the crew of the USS Protostar. We have Del and Murph together in a set. Hologram Janeway, Gwendolyn, Jankum Pog, Zero. 14 points of articulation each. They're 5 inches tall. And according to the report, the figures will be available starting in March and April for $14.99 US each. Still more than what we spent when we were kids. And new to New York City, Kanunian Singh, Near the Great White Way. New York's Peekskill Productions has announced the world premiere of Con the Musical, a parody trektacular, opening May 4th for a 5-week limited run engagement at Off-Broadway's Players Theater. Now, the official description has this as a production put together by Data, a campy musical adaptation of The Wrath of Con with a coming of middle age story. Kirk and his nemesis in a cat and mouse game complete with Vulcan tap dancing, Kirk's long-lost Shatner impersonator son, and mutant space chickens. Because, of course. Show is co-written and composed by Brent Black. It'll run through June 4th. We'll have a link to the site in the notes. And it's probably still not enough to get me to go to New York anytime soon. And that's the report for this week. Thanks very much for being here, folks. Don't forget to like and share and subscribe and all of that good stuff. We'll have more Star Trek and Orville news next week.
Copyright 2023 by Flaming Dog Media, LLC. All rights reserved. No portion of this program may be retransmitted without the express written consent of Flaming Dog Media. You're watching Sci-Fi for Me TV, delivering the multiverse since 2009.